Hello friends, in this segment of valence bond theory today we will see the application of valence bond theory to square planar complex. Example of square planar complex, tetracyanonucleate 2. This is anionic complex. There is a negative charge on the square bracket because three types of complexes are there. Cationic complex, anionic complex and neutral complex. So here it is an example of what anionic complex. So tell me coordination number of nickel here. Here ligands are CN minus. How many ligands are there? 4. And we know that CN minus is monodentate ligand. So the coordination number of nickel is 4. And we know that when coordination number of any metal or metal ion is 4, then what type of hybridization present in this complex? Either sp3 or dsp2. Remember, when hybridization is sp3, then geometry is tetrahedral. And when hybridization is a dsp2, then geometry is a square planar. So remember, this is an example of what? DSP2. And the geometry of this complex is what? Square planar. So we'll see how. What is step number one? So first we must know that is oxidation number of metal. Here metal is nickel. What is oxidation number of nickel? Suppose we don't know. Consider X is the oxidation number of this nickel. How many ligands are there? 4 ligands are there. So 4. Remember, CN, this is CN minus and a minus 1 charge. Because how we write CN minus, this is CN minus. And this ligand carries minus 1. Total number of ligands are 4. So 4 into minus 1 is equal to, what is total charge on this square bracket? That is minus 2. So therefore, X is equal to minus 2 plus 4. And X is equal to plus 2. And what is the oxidation number of nickel here? It is a plus 2. We know that atomic number of nickel is 28. Outer shell electronic configuration is 3d8. And 4 is 2. Then tell me what is the electronic configuration of Ni plus 2. Ni plus 2, the meaning of plus 2 and removal of 2 electrons. So here Ni plus 2. 3d8 and 4 is 0. And this is an example of d8 system. Then how to explain hybridization geometry? So what is step number one? As usual, ground state electronic configuration. This is step number one. Oxidation number of nickel is 2. That is why nickel 2 at a ground state. And a ground state electronic configuration of nickel plus 2. Here you can write argon, this is core element for this nickel. Electronic configuration D8, that is 3D8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is 3D8. 4s0, there is no electron in 4s. 4p also vacant. 4d also vacant. And 4f also vacant. How many empty atomic orbitals are required here? Coordination number of nickel is 4. And in assumptions it is given. Number of empty atomic orbitals in metal is equal to its coordination number. Here coordination number of nickel is 4. Cn minus is monodentate ligand. So 4 empty atomic orbitals are required. Here lot of empty atomic orbitals are available. So this is the ground state electronic configuration of nickel, that is nickel plus 2. What is step number 2? Ni plus 2, that is nickel 2 at excited state. But what what is condition for excitation? Remember, when ligands are weak, there is no excitation. When there is attack of weak ligands on metal or metal ion, there is no excitation of electrons. And in complex, excitation and inner pairing of electrons and shifting of outer shell electrons into inner shell. Here Cn minus is very strong ligand. In spectrochemical series, it is given. Cn minus CO, that is Cn minus CO, that is carbonyl ligand. Cn minus, these are very strong ligands. So here Cn attack of four strong ligands. So due to attack of four strong ligands, there is an inner pairing of electrons. So what happens? Shifting of this unpaired electron in this atomic orbital. What is condition for inner pairing? At least empty atomic orbital or hole is required. What is hole? Hole and atomic orbital with single electron. Here it is. Here two holes are there. So shifting of this electron in this atomic orbital. This is known as inner pairing of electrons. This is known as inner shifting of electrons. This is known as excitation of, isn't it? Excitation of electrons. Inner pairing of electrons. So what is excited state electronic configuration? When there is attack of four strong ligands. Now here two electrons already present. Here two electrons. Here two electrons. Now here it is pairing. Now this is 3D. 8. 4S. 4P. How many empty atomic orbitals are required? 4. Only 4 empty atomic orbitals are required. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Lot of empty atomic orbitals are there. What is step number 3? Step number 3. Nickel 2 at hybridized state. Nickel 2 at hybridized state. And mixing and recasting of atomic orbitals here. But here empty atomic orbitals. Because ligand gives pair of electron. Pair, one pair. And any ligand gives one pair of electron. That is monodentate ligand, it gives one pair of electron. Bidentate ligand gives two pair of electrons. Tridentate, three pairs. Hexadentate, six pairs. Here coordination number is 4. Cn minus is monodentate ligand. So how many empty atomic orbitals are required? 4 empty atomic orbitals are required. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in mixing and recasting of atomic orbitals here, 3D, 4S, and how many 4P? 2. Yani, this 3D, 8 remains as it is. Electrons are paired. And mixing and recasting of 1, 2, 3, 4, and a 1D, 1S, and 2P. That is why this is an example of what DSP2, D, S, and 2P. So this is an example of what? DSP2. DSP2. And in these hybridized orbitals, now here it is the first Cn minus. Consider cross and electrons of Cn minus. When Cn minus gives electrons in a pair of electrons, so if these two cross. Second Cn minus, third Cn minus, and fourth Cn minus. So DSP2. And remember, when hybridization is a DSP2, this is 3D. Which D atomic orbital is the part of hybridization? 3D, not 4D. Because due to inner pairing of electrons, inner shifting of electrons, one 3D is available, that is for hybridization. So DSP2. And when hybridization is a DSP2, what is geometry? Geometry is a square planar. Geometry is a square planar. And we know that square planar and a DSP2. SP3 and a tetrahedral, SP3, here inner 3D is available, that is by DSP2, and DSP2 and a square planar. Now tell me about magnetic moment of this complex. Since all electrons are paired, This complex is diamagnetic. There is no unpaired electron. So magnetic characters, magnetic properties. This is diamagnetic. There will be magnetic moment of this diamagnetic complex. Yes. When complex is diamagnetic, magnetic moment is zero. Yani, magnetic moment of this complex is zero. Because all electrons are paired. There is no unpaired electron. So magnetic moment of this complex is zero. So what is conclusion? Tetracyanonucleate 2 is an example of DSP2. Geometry square planar complex. And this is the application of this what VBP to what? Square planar complex. Another example. Take tetra amine copper 2. Tetra amine copper 2. Tetra amine copper 2. Tetra amine copper 2. Positive complex. Here it is positive charge. So this is cationic complex. So tetra amine copper 2 is the IUPAC name of this complex. Now here coordination number is 4. Because ammonia is a monodentate ligand. Ammonia is strong ligand, no doubt. It is strong ligand. In spectrochemical series it is given. And ammonia is a strong ligand. Ammonia is a monodentate ligand. It gives only one pair to metal or metal ion. So ammonia is monodentate ligand. NH3. Ammonia is a neutral ligand. On the basis of charge. Ammonia is a neutral ligand. Ammonia is a monodentate ligand. Then tell me what is coordination number of copper here? Yes. Coordination number of copper is 4. And how many empty atomic orbitals are required? Again 4. Because coordination number of copper is equal to 4. And it is given in valence bond theory. That is the number of empty atomic orbitals equal to its coordination number. So your coordination number of copper is 4. And how many empty atomic orbitals are required? Only 4. Coordination number 4. Ammonia is monodentate neutral ligand. Now tell me oxidation number of copper. Consider X. How many? Yes, 4. 4 ligands are there, 4. Ammonia carries null charge. There is no charge. N is 0. Is equal to. What is total charge on this complex? It is plus 2. Therefore, oxidation number of copper is a plus 2. And in this complex, copper is present in its plus 2 oxidation state. And we know that atomic number of copper is 29. Outer shell electronic configuration of copper is 3d9 4s2. Is it correct? Yes, no. This is expected electronic configuration of copper. But actually, what is correct electronic configuration and observed electronic configuration in copper? 3d10 4s1. Reason is extra stability. To acquire extra stability, shifting of one electron from 4s to what? 3d. Now 3d10, and it is completely fulfilled. When D10, D5 and D0, that electronic configuration is said to be stable electronic configuration. So the electronic configuration of copper is 3D10 and 4S1. In this complex, what is oxidation number of copper? Plus 2. And removal of 2 electrons. Yani electronic configuration of Cu plus 2 is 3D9 and 4S0. Because removal of 1 electron from 4S and 1 from 3D. So 3d9 and 4s0. So what is step number 1? Ground state electronic configuration NaCu plus 2 at a ground state. Cu plus 2 at a ground state. step number 1, Cu plus 2 at its ground state. Again, core element is argon. If you want to write, you can write that is argon. 3D 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 3D 9. D9 system. 4 is 0. 4P 0. 4D 0. 4F 0. How many empty atomic orbitals are required? Coordination number 4, and only 4 empty atomic orbitals are required. And lot of empty atomic orbitals are there. We want only 4. Now, what is step number 2? Step 2nd. Cu plus 2 at excited state. At excited state. When excitation is there, when there is attack of strong ligands on metal or metal ion, ammonia is a strong ligand. And remember, when attack of 4 strong ligands, definitely there is an excitation. And in complex, generally what happens? Inner shifting of electrons, inner pairing of electrons, when there is attack of strong ligands. Here 4 strong ligands are there. Here it is 1 unpaired electron. And when attack of 4 ammonia, on this complex, that is metal or metal ion. So what happens? Shifting of this electron, but there is no space for inner pairing of electrons. All electrons, here this atomic orbitals fulfilled, that is 2 electrons, here 2 electrons, here 2 electrons, here 2 electrons. There is no hole. Hole and atomic orbital with single electron. Condition for this excitation, at least one hole is required. Yani, for shifting of electrons, one hole is required. An atomic orbital with single electron is required. Here, all electrons, all atomic orbitals are fulfilled. So what happens here? Now shifting of this unpaired electron in 4p. Na, Cu plus 2 at excited state, an excited state electronic configuration. Here all electrons are paired 3D. Now here one 3D empty atomic orbital. Here it is 4S and 4P. Here it is electron. After excitation, shifting of 3D electron, this unpaired electron in 4P, when there is attack of 4 strong ligands, no need to show that it's 4D, 4F, because we want only 4 empty atomic orbitals. Now, step number 3. Cu plus 2 at hybridized state. And mixing and recasting of atomic orbitals here, 4 empty atomic orbitals here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And mixing and recasting of 1 3D, 4S and 2P. These paired electrons remains as it is. Like this. Mixing and recasting of 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3D, this is a D, so D, this is S, so S, and these two NF2P. And remember, this is unhybridized. This is unhybridized. And here, mixing and recasting of 1D, 1S, and what? 2P. And a type of hybridization is a DSP2. Here it is the first ammonia. Here it is second ammonia. Here it is third ammonia. Here it is the fourth ammonia. And this is the formation of tetraamine copper 2. Now tell me magnetic moment of this, magnetic characters of this. Hybridization is a dsp2, and we know that when hybridization is a dsp2, what is geometry of this complex? Geometry square planar. Geometry is square planar. And here it is copper, that is Cu plus 2. And here attack of ligands. It is like this. So this is the geometry. Now what about magnetic characters? Paramagnetic or diamagnetic? Here it is one unpaired electron. Na, magnetic properties. Magnetic properties. It is a paramagnetic. It is a paramagnetic. Now, what is a magnetic moment? We know that formula mu n is equal to square root of n into n plus 2. What is n? N and a number of unpaired electrons. Here it is one unpaired electron. And here n is equal to what? 1. N square root of 1 into 1 plus 2. N square root of 3. This is the magnetic moment of this complex. Complex is paramagnetic. One unpaired electron is there. So magnetic moment is square root of 3 Bm. That is Bm yane Bohr magneton. Hybridization dsp2. Then my simple question. In a dsp2 hybridization, which d atomic orbital is the part of hybridization out of 5? Dxy, dyz, dxz, dx square minus y square, and dz square. Which d atomic orbital is the part of hybridization? This is very important concept. See here, explanation of this. Geometry of this complex is square planar. Square planar. Coordination number 4. Attack of strong ligands. So geometry dsp2. Hybridization dsp2. And geometry is what? Square planar. And what is structure of this? Square planar. It is like this. Here it is Cu plus 2. Attack of 4 strong ligands. Here it is first ammonia. Second ammonia. Third and fourth square planar. Suppose this is the x axis and this is the y axis. Here it will be z axis. How many diatomic orbitals? Dxy, dyz, dxz, dx square minus y square, and dz square. Now tell me which d atomic orbital is the part of this hybridization. Hybridization is a dsp2, and there is only one d atomic orbital is there. These are d atomic orbitals dxy, dyz, dxz, dx square minus y square, and dz square. So out of 5, which d atomic orbital is the part of this hybridization? See here, this is x axis, we have taken this y axis, this is z axis. Now tell me, what is the shape of dxy? And what is the position of electron density in case of dxy? So remember, dxy lies in between x and y axis, in between. Dyz, in between y and z axis. Dxz, in between x and z axis. But what about dx square minus y square? Remember, dx square minus y square lies along x and y axis. And there is a more interaction between dx square minus y square and four ligands. Because dx square minus y square directly pointed towards what? Ligands. What about dz square? This is along z axis. And a dz square is away from ligands. Similarly, dxy away from ligands. Dxz away from ligands. But dx square minus y square directly pointed towards ligand. There is a more interaction between dx square minus y square and four ligands. Yani, dx square minus y square is the part of dsp2. This is a very important concept. Question may be like this: which d atomic orbital is the part of dsp2? Isn't it? In so many competitive exam, it has been asked. So which d atomic orbital is the part of this hybridization? Remember dx square minus y square, because directly bonded towards what? Four ligands. Is it okay? Any doubt? Thank you.